So this sample, it's a very, very interesting sample. It's arsenic. Okay, so this is mathy quality arsenic.
So arsenic used to be much more common in the community than it is nowadays. It was used as a pigment in the 19th century for green wallpaper. It contained copper arsenite. And because there weren't any other good green pigments to make the wallpaper. And when the rooms were damp and the Victorians didn't like opening the windows in their rooms, then mold would grow on the wall. And because arsenic is poisonous to most life forms, the mold would convert the arsenic into a volatile compound, trimethyl arsine, and the trimethyl arsine went into the air, and several people were killed by the arsenic coming from their wallpaper.
Now, arsenic, as we all know, is very toxic, and there have been a number of very high profile and very famous cases of people that have poisoned perhaps their partners or their business partners using arsenic. Okay, so I'm going to very, very carefully take this vial out. This is very carefully, and he knocks it really hard.
Arsenic was also used quite widely by people to dispose of husbands, wives, lovers, though now it is much less common. It is used in the electronics industry for making for getting electronic properties, for making transistors, and also it is still sometimes used for feeding for medication for feeding to livestock. It's only quite recently that the use of arsenic has been banned as an additive to chicken feed in the United States.
So here you see the arsenic powder. Okay, now this is a metallic, very dark metal, but I'm not going to open this because, like I said, it's very, very toxic. Very dark metallic sample. You can see very, very fine powder in the bottom of this vial. Now I'm going to put this back in before I get it on my skin because it's a very toxic material and I don't want to expose myself.